me so wild.
How can I? Okay, hey lovely ladies, it's Beautiful 94. And I know it's been forever since I last uploaded a video. And I thought I was way past due, and plus I have a new hairstyle. So I thought it would only be right for you guys to see what I'm doing. And actually, like, I did these guys yesterday, but one of my braids, when I curled the ends, it didn't take. So I just thought I'd come on here and show you guys how to do it real quick. All right. I believe in conditioner because I am natural, so I want to make sure that my hair stays moisturized. So this is a leave-in conditioner by Eden, and it's a coconut shea. I just like the way it makes my hair feel and everything. It's not too clunky. It doesn't leave residue. And then I'm using the Fantasia's Thick and Shine Styling Gel. I love this gel. Again, it doesn't leave your hair feeling all clunky. And it actually makes the braids stay and, like, the hair not pop out. So that's why I love it. And the hair that I use, I'm using this Expressions Ultra Braid. So this is, like, really long braid. And actually, I got this for... Okay, so the price in here was priced incorrectly. It wasn't $2.99. It was really $4.99. But I talked to a guy to give it to me for $3.99 since all the ones that I had this on it. And then you see it's an Ultra Braid Premium color too. These braids are so long, but I don't need to open that. Like, I bought... I bought 3 packs of blonde, but I don't know where I put the extra bundle, because I ended up only using 2 bundles of that, so I had 1 bundle left, and it was just this color, because my actual hair is that color, so I'm like, let me not go too much and do the whole thing, even though I might do that next, but I just thought, you know, just blend it in with some black should be fine. Okay, so first things first is that you need to have your hair at least moisturized. So I'm putting in my leave-in conditioner. I'm gonna comb through it since these, it already should have a little bit of stuff in it. Okay, and then I'm gonna put my Fantasia's gel in the section that I want to work on first. So, I have about 3 braids right here. So, I'm going to part this section, leaving about, I don't want to say, not that much space. I mean, how much would you say that? I would say about 1 inch. Mine are about 1 inch in depth and about 2 centimeters in width. I just do that so my hair will be fuller, because every time I do braids, it seems to look like they're just like scarce. And I wanted a really full look this time because I have, like, they're not jumble twists, but they're kind of big twists. Okay, so... like I said, I already had my hair sectioned off. When you want to section this hair off, especially if you're getting the extra long braid, it's good to put it over a door handle. It's good to put it over a door handle and take it off like that, because, like, the first time that I did it, like, the first pack of hair, I completely wasted it because it all got tangled together. So once you, like, get... a hang of it should be good. But all right, so, and mind you, the hair was much longer than this. It was maybe, I want to say it was long as, like, it was about 3 foot broken half like this. So it was super long, like it was about 5 feet long, just laying on the floor. So definitely like take your time when you're doing it. So I'm gonna first start with this piece right here. And I'm just gonna put some of my gel on there. Put as much as you want. I'm gonna put this much just because it's the front and I really want it to stay. So you wanna saturate that throughout your hair. I'm sorry, guys. It's so early in the morning. Okay. And then what I do the invisible twist method. So let me scoot that up close. So what you're really honestly gonna do is you're gonna take your hair, the piece that you're using to twist, split it in half, just like that. So you see I have two pieces, and then you're gonna put your hair in, of course, in half, and you're gonna put it right in between the two pieces that you are starting. So it should look like this, okay? And then what I'm gonna just do, I learned how to freehand this, but just because I want you guys to stay with me, I'm going to twist one side at a time for you, but I'm going to use a clip so it'll stay. So I'm going to clip the front piece down. If I can get it. I hate these little black clips. I'm just going to use this clip. So you're going to do that. This is just the extra hair I had that I need to braid. So you see the this side is clipped down. And all you're going to do is take the front piece and you're just going to twist to your right. Twist to your right until all the hair is twisted. This helps to keep your hair and your braid together. And also it creates an invisible, like, an invisible section. So you won't be able to, like, you know, see your twist. So this is what it looks like completely twisted. The front of my hair is kind of short because of heat damage, so it's not that much to twist. And then you're just going to put it this braid in between, then you're just going to twist the same to the right again. Make sure it's nice and tight, and then after you twist, you're just going to twist down. And then the main twist is going to be twisted to the left. And you're just going to go all the way down. And then you can see that's what the twist looks like. So it's not a big clunky like twist at the top. It makes it look a little bit more natural. I'm not going to say this is a natural hairstyle because it's kind of a bold hairstyle. My boyfriend actually calls them Hoochie Mamas. But I like them, and that's all that matters. Anywho, so you're just going to keep twisting down. Keep going. Okay. I'm gonna actually already boil these ends, but I think I can boil them again. So I'm just gonna keep going, and then I'm gonna put a curler rod at the bottom. Okay. So when you get to the bottom of these, what I did, instead of burning the ends, I wanted to create like a wave effect. So I just took my rod, twisted around. So I'm tucking the ends in, and then I'm just going to twist the hair over top of the ends so the ends will stay down. Because since I had to cut them, it made it impossible, I tell you, to get the ends to stay. And the boiling method really helps to keep them, you know, stay. Because, like, look, these didn't get boiled. This one didn't get boiled. And, look, it's coming apart. All of these, they're good, and I slept on them. Okay, so you see how the braid looks. It's a nice, could be better, but it's a nice braid. And the front of my hair is like that. So it doesn't look like I have a big old chunky braid in my head. So I talked you through one. I'm going to move on to the next one. Okay, and the very last thing that I like to do is my baby hair, of course. put my hair back. Okay, so I just did this hairstyle, so I'm gonna have to get used to like the hair just getting everywhere. Okay, so use my Eco Styler gel, and I use the Cura Care Edge Tamer. Love this stuff. It's great for natural hair. But okay. And then I'm gonna boil these guys. I put the hair directly into boiling water. Of course, it's not plugged up. I just put it on there for about 5 to 10 seconds and then take them out. Make sure you have a towel so you can catch the ends, just so they won't burn you, and make sure the hair doesn't touch the pot, and keep them away from the bottom of the keep the braids away from the bottom of the pan. I don't know if it'll burn them, but I just make sure I keep a hold on the couple that I'm dipping into so I can have control over it. And yeah, so if you have any questions or any concerns, just ask me. I always answer back. I just am a slacker on, actually posting videos. But yeah, I will definitely upload the link to the person that I learned how to do the invisible braiding part to. And again, any questions, just ask me. I have nothing better to do. All right, see you guys later. Bye.